Eve Harow, Director of Tourism and Community Development for One Israel Fund. Today in Hermesh with Elad Elimelech, who is the Chief of Security in this beautiful community here in the Northern Shomron. So some of the donors of One Israel Fund are not strangers to Hermesh because we've done some security projects here, but today I'm here not for security, specifically for the Pinot Chamot, for the soldier's corner, the warm corner. We've done quite a few warm corners, Pinot Chamot, in different communities for the soldiers in our country.
Thank you for coming here to Hermesh, first of all. I want to talk about the place we're standing here. First of all, this is a garden that we built for to remember the kids that was murdered here in 2002. We have a terrorist that came into the settlement and killed two little girls, 14 years old, and we want to remember them. So we made this project to bring back life where was death. We have the Pinot Chamot to the soldiers. Something to make the soldiers feel closer to the settlement, closer to the people that live here. We can go inside and show you what we've done.
Not everybody understands that in the Israeli army, the soldiers aren't protecting their homes, they're protecting the country. So for example, my kids, one of my sons served on the Lebanese border, even though we live in Gush Etzion. Another daughter was a spotter, Tatzpitanit, on the border with Gaza. And one of my other sons just did reserve duty on the border with Egypt. So soldiers go where they're sent, where the army decides they are needed, depending on what unit they're in. And a lot of soldiers come to the places, come to the yeshuvim, come to the communities in Yehuda v'Shomron, and aren't necessarily familiar with them, don't necessarily have the political opinions of the people that live here. And we want to connect ourselves to the soldiers, the communities to the soldiers to the community, because it doesn't matter where we live in the land of Israel, we are all one people and we all need to protect each other and put everything aside for the good of the country. So to have a Pinot Chamot here in Hermesh is incredibly important for the soldiers who come here and really aren't familiar with the area, don't know anyone who's here, and are far from home. So what kind of soldiers come in here? How many soldiers come in here?
We have, at any time, we have 5 soldiers living here in the settlement, and they have no place to come to drink coffee. That's why we built this place. Beyond that, we have all the
patrols.
The patrols, exactly. The patrols that come inside 2-3 times in each hour. They want to go in and drink a cup of coffee because mm-hmm. they have nowhere else. So we built this place so they can sit, watch television in the future,
right.
Drink a bit of coffee. We buy all kinds of cookies and stuff for them.
Right.
Coffee, refrigerator, microwave, whatever they need to relax from.
Right. And they don't pay for anything? Everything is a gift
from
the community?
No, everything is a gift from the community. People come and put whatever they want. And just leave it here.
The sages say that the second temple was destroyed because of Sinat Chinam, because of baseless hatred, and we went into a long and very painful exile. So the way to repair that is Ahavat Chinam, is just giving of ourselves, giving to people that we don't even know. And that's what this community can do for the soldiers, because the soldiers are giving a lot to the community. And that kind of love and that kind of connection is much more than in just a cookie and a cup of coffee.
החדר הזה בגדול קודם כל נקרא סטודיו צלילי הדס על שם הדס טורג'מן שנרצחה פה בפיגוע ב-2002. אבא שלה רצה להקים את המקום והיה את השלט המון המון שנים והמקום לא הצליח לקום כי לא היה אף אחד שהתעסק עם זה. וזה משהו שאני והוועד הנוכחי לקחנו על עצמנו בעקבות פיגוע שהיה פה ב-2016. 2016 היה פיגוע דריסה ליד מבוא דותן ואני הגעתי לשם בין הראשונים, הייתה זירה מאוד קשה. ואחרי הפיגוע הגיעו חיילים לפה ששמרו פה ביישוב, אבל הוקפצו לשם לאירוע, וישבו בערב עם גיטרות, והאווירה הייתה מאוד נמוכה. ואז עלה הרעיון לשלב את זה בעצם עם הקהילה, ולתת להם מקום שגם הנוער יוכל לבוא לשבת איתם וטיפה להוציא אותם מהמקום הזה, והם יוכלו, יהיה להם מקום יותר ביתי מאשר לשבת במוצב שמשאיר אותם תקועים בתוך האירוע הזה. ועכשיו הצלחנו להתחיל לפחות לגלגל את הרעיון, השאיפה היא למלא פה בכלי נגינה, ולהתחיל להפעיל את המקום בשיתוף גם עם הצבא וגם עם כל הנוער שגודל פה בעצם, שהם יקבלו מהחיילים והחיילים יקבלו מהם, ויהיה פה איזשהו איחוד של הקהילה.
If we're successful in raising the funds, and that's up to those of you who are watching this, this room can be a music room, a place where both the youth of the community and the soldiers that come here can play music together, can relax together, can kind of dissipate some of the tensions of the day and of their jobs and of the difficult things that they have to do. Remember, the youth are future soldiers. And so this room, we want to be filled with laughter and with music. Right now it's empty. We need you to help us fill it. One Israel Fund is particularly proud of what we do for our soldiers, both our sons and daughters, and some of your sons and daughters, and also the reserve soldiers who do their duty every single year. We support and build Pinot Chamot, warm corners, in different parts of Yehuda Shomron, a place where they can come, get a piece of cake, get a cup of tea, whatever is it they need. Now, the one in Elon Moreh behind me is a very special one, because it's not just a little house where they can go in and take their boots off and relax for a minute, but it's built in a very particular place with a view to the area that they're also guarding. And so this particular Pinot Chamot, and the reason for its large windows, is because they will come here not just to grab a nash, but stay here all night, view what's happening here, keep the people in Elon Moreh safe while we keep them fed and happy. It's a partnership. People will come here, every family takes a different day, makes sure to bring cake, sometimes it's something a little more substantial. It's a partnership between the army and the people that live here. Remember, a lot of the soldiers, they've never been to this area. They don't necessarily understand or support what's happening here. And when we connect them as people to people, the people living here, the soldiers coming to guard them, the people living here who are sending their sons and daughters to guard the places where these soldiers' family lives, that's what makes the strength of a nation. That kind of partnership, the partnership between the people living here and those of you who are physically not here, but with your contributions to One Israel Fund, showing that we are One Israel.